It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
Yes, Kara Kat is feeling good, as she should. She will be singing for Kazakhstan at Junior Eurovision 2020. She is ready to hashtag move the world. Kara Kat, hello, how are you?
Привет, Кара Кат. Очень приятно тебя видеть. Как у тебя дела?
Спасибо большое. У меня все отлично. Как у вас?
Thank you very much. I'm fine. And how are you?
Oh, I'm doing amazing. Thank you for asking. Now, this is a bit of a complicated setup. We're trying a new filming system. Could you tell us where you are, where we're talking right now?
Я нахожусь в Казмедиа. Именно тут проходил национальный отбор Junior Eurovision.
I'm in Kazmedia, and right here, the national selection took place.
Now, please forgive me, just to make sure, how do I say your name, Kara Kat?
Правильно произносится Кара Кат, в переводе «черная смородина». Меня так называют, потому что у меня глаза как черная смородина.
It actually spelled Kara Kat, and in translation it's blackberry. I was named like this because my eyes are like blackberry.
Blackberry, a wonderful fruit, love that. Now tell us, what made you want to sing at Junior Eurovision in the first place?
Вначале, когда мы сидели с сестрой, сестра увидела пост, где написано, что проходит конкурс детское Евровидение. Мне очень понравилась эта идея, и мне захотелось поучаствовать в конкурсе, потому что был шанс выступить с авторской песней.
My sister saw on Instagram that there is a song contest Junior Eurovision, and I really like that idea because there is a chance to perform my own song.
But of course, you did not just sing, you sang really, really well. This was a competitive national selection, a lot of talented performers, many good songs. Did you think that you were going to win during the process itself?
Да, вы правы. Были очень много хороших песен. Все финалисты очень талантливые, но для меня самое главное — это не победа, а чтобы все услышали меня.
Yes, you're right. All the participants were very talented and they had great songs. But for me, it was important to be heard, not to win at all.
Oh, that's a lovely message. And Kazakhstan clearly heard you. What was your reaction when you won?
Если честно, я ничего не помню. Но помню, что я была в шоке и не могла выразить свои эмоции.
To say truly, I don't really remember what I felt. And the only thing that I remember that I couldn't express my feelings.
Well, in the song, you definitely express your feelings. Forever is a very big ballad. You've got some big notes, lots of emotion there. Could you explain the meaning to those of us who may not understand the lyrics?
Трек мне написал Хамид Шангалиев, и мне очень повезло с ним, потому что прежде чем писать трек, Он всегда беседует с исполнителем. Мы с ним разговаривали больше часу. И когда он у меня спросил, про что я хочу петь, я сказала, что хотела бы посвятить эту песню папе. Клип мы посвятили всем отцам всего мира, которые уходят на опасные профессии. И этим я хотела сказать, что их дома ждут родные и дети, верят в то, что все будет хорошо. И это моя история, и ею я хочу поделиться со всеми. И думаю, что эта песня станет одой всех детей на свете.
My composer was the composer of the song was Hamid Shangaliyev, and I was really lucky to have him. First of all, we talked him more than an hour, and then he asked me what about I want to sing, and then I told him that the song is gonna be I want to dedicate my song with my father. The music video is about the fathers that leave to the little work, and it's about the kids that waiting for them, and I want to be heard that because it's my story, and I think my song is going to become an ode for the kids around the world.
You reference your father who passed away sadly a few years ago. It's a very personal, very emotional topic. When you first got the song, was it difficult to sing?
Когда я должна была исполнить эту песню впервые, мне было очень сложно, потому что эта песня для меня многое значит, и она очень эмоциональная. И мне было очень трудно, но я тогда подумала, как бы я спела эту песню перед папой, и как бы он мной гордился на тот момент. И потом после этого я собралась и выступила. И каждый раз перед выступлением я думаю об этом.
For the first time, it was really hard to perform the song. This is really emotional song, and it means for me a lot. But at that moment I thought that, what if my father would hear me, and how proud of me he would be. And then I forced myself to perform this song.
And you speak so eloquently on the subject. I'm curious, what advice do you have for other children or even other adults who are struggling with the loss of a loved one?
Главное не останавливаться и идти дальше. И если даже их с нами нет рядом, то они все равно смотрят на нас сверху и помогают и всегда поддерживают нас.
It's really important to move on, and even they are not with us, they are watching us, looking after us, and they are helping us and supporting us.
Thank you so much for sharing that. It's really hard to discuss the loss of our relatives and our friends, whether you're a kid or an adult, so I really appreciate you sharing that. Now that we know the context of the song, would you mind singing a little bit of it for us?
Да, конечно.
Remember days, I hope to stay. I never really want you to go away, away. From your way. Another day I didn't say, I think I did it, 'cause my heart can say I love.
with love.
Ooh, we see why you won. Now, Junior Eurovision 2020 is taking on a different form. Rather than all coming together, you'll be filming individual performances because of the pandemic. I'm curious, were you sad to find out that Junior Eurovision would be different this year?
И да, я была очень сильно расстроена, потому что, к сожалению, из-за пандемии мы не можем встретиться. Но мы сейчас переписываемся, у нас есть общий чат, и мы планируем провести прямые эфиры. Так что подписывайтесь на меня. Но говорят, что в Польше очень классно. Я смотрела картинки, там реально очень красиво. А всех остальных ребят я буду рада увидеть в Казахстане.
I was really upset that unfortunately, because of the global pandemic, we cannot meet each other with other participants. But we have a group chat and we plan to have live translate Instagram live. And so you can follow my Instagram. And what about Poland? It's really amazing there. And I heard that it's really cool in there, and I saw pictures, and I would really like to visit Poland. And what about other participants? I hope they gonna visit Kazakhstan.
And how's it gonna work? Are you gonna film your performance at a studio in Kazakhstan, or are you going to travel to Poland and film your performance there?
Выступление мы будем снимать здесь, в Казахстане, в Алмате.
We're going to film our my performance in Kazakhstan here in Almaty.
And what about Kazakhstan's previous contestants, Danlia and Yerjan? Have you met them? Have you talked to them about Junior Eurovision?
С Данелем мы еще не встречались, но с Ержаном мы вместе выступали.
I haven't met Danelia yet, but with Yerjan we performed together.
Now, you're 12 years old today, but you've been singing since you were just 5 years old. What were you singing when you were 5?
Если честно, я не помню, что я пела в 5 лет, но на тот момент я пела только казахские песни.
If to say truly, I don't remember what I was singing at that moment, but I remember that I was singing only Kazakh songs.
And in your bio, you mentioned that you watched a lot of YouTube when you were younger and that you found a lot of inspirational singers there. Who inspired you on YouTube?
Меня вдохновляет Тина Кароль, а песня, которая мне нравится, это Feeling Good в исполнении Майкла Бубли.
Тина Кароль inspires me, and my favorite song is Feeling Good by Michael Bublé.
Oh, bonjour, Michael Bublé. Yes, Canada is calling. He is beloved all over the world. Could you sing a little bit of Monsieur Bublé?
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me. And I'm feeling good.
You take your music very seriously and you actually go to a musical boarding school. Could you tell us a little bit about that?
Я учусь в республиканской музыкальной школе-интернат, которая названа в честь народной оперной певицы Клёш Байсеитовой. Моя специальность — скрипка, а фортепиано считается обязательным инструментом.
I study in Republican music boarding school named after Kuliash Bahitova, a Kazakh national opera singer. And I study in specialty violin, and I have also piano lessons that are required.
And it's named after an opera singer, actually. So do you want to pursue opera? Do you enjoy opera?
Да, конечно, я хочу петь оперу, но у меня пока не получается.
Yes, I want to sing opera, but unfortunately I can't.
Finally, do you have a message for all of your new fans on obiwiblogs.com?
Спасибо, что вы меня поддерживаете. Надеюсь, что мы скоро встретимся, и я вас люблю.
Thank you all for your support, and I hope we will meet soon, and I love you.
Oh, Karakat, thank you so much for taking the time to chat with us. It's so nice to learn more about you, your song, your background, and even if Junior Eurovision is a little bit different this year, I'm sure you're going to have an amazing experience, and we will be following you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.